Well, out of all those spare parts, this is what we have. Just point out a few things. I made this my ground output, two screw terminals. These two right here, the first two are fixed at 5 volt. This is variable between 9 and 12 by turning that potentiometer. This is the regulator for the 5 volt. I wanted to make sure they had plenty of current for whatever projects I may do. So the 5 volts got its own regulator. The 9 to 12 volts got its own regulator. It does have reverse voltage protection. It's also on board the chip. The chip has protections on board.
Okay.
There's Timothy Paul. The indicator lights. This is a 9 to 20 volt input. I'm using a universal power supply right now to get 9 volt DC in. I'll go ahead and turn it on. It took a couple hours to make. The red is to indicate that the supply power is good. So as long as that's lit, I know that's good. Green light tells me that my 5 volt supply is good. The only thing I haven't hooked up yet is this. There's a red LED right here, and that will be my 9 to 12 volt indicator right here for the 9 to 12 volt rail. And if my ground probe is in good enough, let's see what we get. I'm going to go across, try the 5 volt. There we go. Very well regulated. So I can put about a half a milliamp, well, 500 milliamp load. And here's our 9 to 12 volt side. 11.54. And let's see, can I measure VN? Looking for a good test point. I don't see a test point, but the input. Oh, yeah, I can. My meter's jumping around, but it's supposed to be 9 volt in. Anyway, that's what I built out of a couple broken remotes, a 15-year-old telephone, and I'll use this to power my Arduino projects instead of using the power supply on the main board. I'll put a link to the schematic up on circuit to Circuit Lab in the description box.